sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Porcupine, covered with a protective coat of slender, sharp, hollow quills, the porcupine escapes its enemies by raising its bristles threateningly. Native Americans valued porcupine quills for quill working, a process in which dyed quills were used to decorate a wide variety of items, moccasins, knife sheaths, tobacco bags, buffalo robes, and ceremonial clothing. Legends often describe quill working as the sacred gift of a culture hero or heroine, such as a Nog-Ite. The double-faced woman. Porcupine appears in various tales as the companion of coyote or beaver. In Plains Indian tales, coyote frequently went buffalo hunting with porcupine and tricked him out of his share of the meat. In Mi'kmaq mythology, porcupine controlled cold weather. Powwow, originally a Narragansett word meaning shaman or medicine man. It may also have been used to name tribal ceremonies conducted by a tribe's shaman or spiritual elders. Over time, a powwow came to mean a gathering of Native American people to celebrate their culture by sharing art, food, and music, and recreating traditional dance and ritual ceremonies. A special double-headed drum called a powwow drum, originally used by Great Plains tribes. The drum is suspended horizontally from a frame and played by four men to produce a deep, distinctive booming sound. Today, many powwow celebrations are open to non-native visitors as a way to promote native crafts and teach visitors about tribal culture and spirituality. Sometimes they are held in large buildings, such as the annual powwow at the Smithsonian Institute's Native American Museum. Others are held outdoors in parks, traditional powwow camps, or even on the open prairie. The event always begins with a grand entry or parade into the center of the powwow, accompanied by drumming, dancing, and musical performances. Young girls are chosen as tribal princesses. Male dancers wear traditional clothing and black-tipped golden eagle feathers, performing such dances as the grass dance, a dance originally used to trample grass before setting up teepees. Female dances have brighter costumes with traditional beaded designs and perform different dancers than the males. Many dancers travel what is called the powwow circuit, dancing and competing at powwows held all over the United States. Prayer sticks, decorated sticks prepared ceremonially as offerings to accompany prayers to bring rain or restore health. Prayer sticks vary in length, shape, painting, carving, and the objects that are attached to them, such as shells and feathers. They are often blessed with tobacco smoke or sacred cornmeal or by other rites. Prayer sticks are placed in springs, in fields, under trees and shrubs, in caves, on altars, or in any other place where spirits might see them and answer the prayers breathed into them. Prayer sticks are used frequently by the Pueblo people. The Acoma Emergence and Migration account relates how after the people emerged from the underworld, the warrior twins, Massiwa and Uyuyewa, taught them how to welcome the Kachinas with offerings of prayer sticks and food. During ceremonies that are still held, Kachina impersonators plant prayer sticks dedicated to the spirits they are impersonating, the Apache and Navajo, Diné, also used prayer sticks. When the warrior twins Monster Slayer and Born for Water went to their father, the sun, for assistance, he gave them prayer sticks that would warn them of danger. The Tohono O'odham hold annual prayer stick ceremonies at the places where they first settle. These ceremonies are held to bring rain and to keep the world in order. During the ceremony, clowns with healing powers circulate among the people. At the end of the ceremony, prayer sticks are given to everyone.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.